opposition parties are set to move the impeachment motion in the Rajya Sabha, 71 legislators from the upper house have signed the motion so far, and now this motion shall be presented to the chairperson of Rajya Sabha. North Korea has put out a statement saying that it has suspended nuclear and long-range missile tests and plans to close its nuclear test site. In a bid to shift its national focus to improving economy, the nation will now secure peace in the Korean Peninsula and create an optimal international environment. In a scathing attack on Prime Minister Narendra Modi, the Shiv Sena has said that the capital of India should be shifted outside the country so that the PM can make statements on important issues. The Sena said that PM Modi becomes a mauni baba when he is in India but speaks up on critical issues on his foreign visits. As the shocking rapes in Kathua and Unnao triggered nationwide outrage and brought into focus the safety of minor girls in India, the Modi government has told the Supreme Court that it proposes to amend the laws to ensure that those guilty of raping children get the death penalty. Government has informed there's a strong indication that high energy swell waves with heights between 2 to 3 meters will occur in the seas surrounding India in the next few days. The west coast and the union territory of Lakshadweep will witness the waves first, followed by the Bay of Bengal. Deputy CM Manish Sisodia, in a letter to PM Modi, has questioned the dismissal of Atishi Marlena, who had been advising Delhi government on education reforms. In a 3-page letter, he drew PM's attention to the hurdles created by his government after the sacking of Marlena. A mentally ill woman allegedly beheaded her child, chopped his body and was found sleeping with it in Outer Delhi's Aman Vihar area last night. The woman had also inflicted injuries to herself and is currently admitted to a hospital. Swedish-born producer and DJ Tim Bergling, popularly known as Avicii, was found dead in Oman. The 28-year-old was a pioneer of the contemporary electronic dance movement and had won 2 MTV Music Awards, 1 Billboard Music Award and earned 2 Grammy nominations. Chennai Super Kings started the new journey in Pune with a resounding win against Rajasthan Royals in the Indian Premier League last night. In this first of 6 home games out in Pune, Chennai registered a 64-run victory to move to the top of the table with their 3rd win this season. Rajnikant's much-awaited film Kala, which was scheduled to release on April 27, was postponed due to the Tamil Nadu Producers Council strike against digital service providers. It was rumored that the film will now release on Ramzan 2018, but movies producer Dhanush has disclosed that Kala will release on June 7 in all languages worldwide.